Hi friends, let's start with our series of solving HackerRank data structure problem in the problem section part, and today we're going to solve left rotation. So basic problem statement given here is that a left rotation operation on an array of size n shift each of the array element one unit to the left, given an integer d, rotate the array that many steps left and return the result. So basically here we have to rotate the array d times. So here our time complexity would become big O of D, which would be the number of rotations that we need to perform. But one way of decreasing the complexity would be performing a modulo operation on the D. So D would become D percentage by so what does this do? So this basic operation, so for example in this case it is perfectly fine. So here 2 modulo by length of array is 5, so the value of the d is 2 itself, which is quite fair enough. But in cases, for example, when the d value is 6, then 6 percentage by length of this array is 5, it's become 1. Okay, so here the time complex, we have reduced the time complexity from the value of d to a value of n. It means n is the length of the array, which is always going to be less than equal to d. Okay, so this is the basic idea, and we have to perform this operation. So once we have done the time, once we have reduced the time complexity of this problem, so for example 6 is okay, but what if the number of rotation you need to perform is 1 million times? So if 1 million times rotation you have to perform, the time complexity would be huge. So basically if you perform a modulo, the value of the time complexity would decrease to a huge extent. So this is the basic idea, and once you have done that, the problem statement is very straightforward. So the array would become array of d. This is called slicing and dicing in Python. I think anybody who's doing Python programming, these are the basics. So in this case it is doing from the dth element to the end of the array, all the values it is printing, means it is appending, it is assigning to this newly assigned array variable. And we have to plus arr of from starting to d. So once you have done that, we would return the value. And once you have returned the value, we would submit the code. As you could see, the test cases pass successfully. So thanks for watching and have a nice day.